President Trump has so far declined to personally comment on allegations of sexual misconduct made against Republican Senate candidate Roy Moore, but he typed out some sharp tweets about assault allegations against Democratic Senator Al Franken. Chief White House correspondent Major Garrett has more on that.
Mr. President, do you believe Roy Moore's accusers?
President Trump has repeatedly declined to answer questions about Alabama Senate candidate Roy Moore. But on Twitter, he was full of outrage over allegations of sexual harassment by Democratic Senator Al Franken. The Al Frankenstein picture is really bad, the president wrote, referring to this 2006 photograph. It shows Franken appearing to grope Leanne Tweeden on a military airplane during a USO tour. Franken has apologized, but the president wondered, where do his hands go in pictures 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 while she sleeps? During the campaign, the release of the Access Hollywood videotape made clear where Mr. Trump thought his hands could go.
And when you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything.
Whatever you want.
Grab him by the I can do anything.
More than a dozen women have accused Mr. Trump of unwanted sexual advances. In the heat of the campaign, Summer Zervos, a former contestant on The Apprentice, leveled this charge.
He put me in an embrace, and I tried to push him away.
The Trump campaign response was a blanket denial and an effort to deflect the controversy by bringing up accusations of sexual misconduct by former President Bill Clinton. Sitting with candidate Trump, Juanita Broderick spoke to the press ahead of the second presidential debate.
But Bill Clinton raped me, and Hillary Clinton threatened me. I don't think there's any comparison.
The national debate over sexual misconduct has led to a reassessment of Mr. Clinton's behavior. An investigation of sexual harassment claims eventually led to his impeachment when he lied under oath about his affair with White House intern Monica Lewinsky.
I misled people, including even my wife. I deeply regret that.
One prominent Senate Democrat, Kirsten Gillibrand of New York, was asked if in today's context, Mr. Clinton should have stepped down.
Yes, I think that is the appropriate response. But I think things have changed today. And I think under those circumstances, there should be a very different reaction.
Back to this White House, Press Secretary Sarah Sanders said today the president has addressed the Roy Moore allegations. He has not. The White House position is they are, quote, extremely troubling, but it's up to the voters of Alabama to decide whether Moore, the Republican nominee, is fit for office.
Major, what do you make of President Trump's different tones toward Moore and Senator Franken?
Well, part of it is partisan, of course. Taking advantage of a situation that is embarrassing for the Senate Democrat Al Franken and distracting from the ongoing controversy and questions that dog Roy Moore and his candidacy in Alabama. What was most interesting today here at the White House is Sarah Sanders, the press secretary, was asked about White House concerns about keeping this Alabama seat, which is currently held by a Republican, Luther Strange, who was appointed to fill the vacancy created when Jeff Sessions was moved from that Senate seat to Attorney General. And Sarah Sanders said, we're not so concerned about this seat. We're concerned about policy decisions the Senate makes as a whole. Well, that's an interesting orientation to this particular special election on December 12th, because if the Democrat, Doug Jones, wins that special election, Republicans will have one fewer Senate member of the Senate, meaning all future legislative matters for this White House will have an even narrower margin to achieve victory in the Senate. And that sort of hands-off approach to the Senate seat currently held by Republicans in Alabama is, I think, the most interesting culmination of what's been a very intense week of non-intervention by this White House.
Major, your piece mentioned the name Juanita Broderick. It was in many cases a history lesson on the evening news. She first made those charges 17 years ago, an incident that happened close to four decades ago. Is something changing? Do you see a broader tipping point in Washington about what's acceptable and what how much you can get away with and keep your job?
I do indeed. I covered the Bill Clinton impeachment for U.S. News and World Report, my employer at the time, and there was a general conversation about either sexual misconduct or allegations thereof, but it never reached a level of, hey, any charge must be accepted seriously and men must react to them and the political culture around the men who are being accused has to look at them in a new way. What was said at the time was, these are accusations that are denied and shouldn't be taken seriously. There was a concerted effort by those who were loyalist to President Clinton to demean and denounce his accusers. Juanita Broderick was not alone in that regard. Mm-hmm. Paula Jones was demeaned. Others were demeaned and questioned and ridiculed for even having the audacity to bring these kind of charges against President Clinton. Those atmospherics existed then. And they were a political cudgel used against these female accusers of the president, quite effectively, and some would say quite ruthlessly. Those tactics, it appears now, number one, no longer apply, and in many instances, wouldn't even be contemplated.
And Major, let's talk about a different subject now. CBS News has confirmed the president will pay his own legal bills and is setting up a fund to cover some fees for staffers involved in the Russia investigation. Is there a precedent for this, and does this raise ethical concerns?
Well, I'm not sure how many ethical concerns it raises, but this issue of legal costs for people who work for a president has come up before. We're going right back to the Bill Clinton investigation. Many people who work for Bill Clinton in the Clinton White House had substantial legal bills. Some people suffered mightily because of the legal expenses they had to endure as a tangential part of any number of investigations into the Clinton White House. And President Clinton didn't have the wherewithal or the inclination to offer any financial support for those White House aides. President Trump is trying to do that as a remedy for their exposure to something he insists is a non-event in both political and legal terms. It's clearly not a non-event in political terms. Whether it's a non-event in legal terms, the special counsel Robert Mueller will tell the nation a lot more about that in the coming months. As far as a precedent for this, I can't remember a time when a president stepped in to cover his own legal expenses without raising money from outside sources or volunteering to do so for those who work on his behalf. But I don't think it's any mystery that there are many things about this White House that lack modern precedent.
Indeed. Major Garrett at the White House, thanks.